And another thing, Atlantic Ocean, if you observe it in a map, it is a S-shaped ocean. This ocean is S-shaped ocean. Next, we are coming to Indian Ocean, the only ocean named after a country. We must be proud of this. This is our own ocean. If you are visiting Kanyakumari anytime, you will be able to see that ocean, experience this ocean from the tip of Kanyakumari. The one is touching, the water bodies you can touch, that is Indian Ocean. And next we are coming to the Arctic Ocean. Indian Ocean, it is almost a triangle shape. It is a triangle shape ocean. Next we are coming to Arctic Ocean. Arctic Ocean is almost frozen and it is in the North Pole, northern side. When we discussed about continents, we have seen Antarctica is the southernmost one and Arctic Ocean is a northernmost ocean in the, it is situated in the North Pole. Next we are coming to atmosphere. I told you atmosphere is made of different type of gases. We cannot see it, but we can feel it. The major part of the atmosphere is made by nitrogen. Nitrogen is almost 71% of the atmosphere is composed by nitrogen gas. Then it is coming oxygen. 21% is we have by oxygen. Oxygen is the most required gas for us. We breathe in oxygen. The only planet we are in, that is Earth, that have oxygen, that has oxygen, and we are benefited, and that is the reason we are the living planet. We can claim ourselves as a living planet, that is oxygen. Next we are coming to carbon dioxide. You all know that we inhale oxygen and we give out carbon dioxide. We have a common idea that carbon dioxide is a very, it is a harmful gas. It is not at all a harmful gas. You know, the warmth, the heat we can feel in our earth, the warmth that is caused by carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide has a capacity to grab the warmth from the sun warmth on the earth, and that is the reason it is not never cool, it is not never chilled planet. So carbon dioxide, which we have an impression that it is a very harmful gas, it is not at all. Rather, carbon dioxide is a gas which help us to grab the warmth and keep our planet warm. We can feel it. It is never so chilled that it is an icy planet. Rather, we have the life is benefited by carbon dioxide. We can see the atmosphere, almost 99%, it is made by nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide, and at least 1% is made up by other gases. So this is the major portion of the of our atmosphere that actually gives us life to breathe and life to live on. We are coming to the next, that is biosphere. Biosphere is the place, is the life place, the living place of Earth, where the plants, the animals, the other biotic, abiotic animals, they all live. So the, wherever in the Earth you can see life, you can see living thing, they are composed the biosphere. Here if we see that in atmosphere, as we go up, the pressure, air pressure decreases. It changes. The air level and air pressure is changing. And depending on that, we also divide it into some sphere like troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, exosphere, and these all are the major spheres we are dividing the Earth. Mostly we live in troposphere. It is all the animals, the biosphere, mostly all the biosphere you will find in between the, in the troposphere, the earth and the troposphere. And then beyond troposphere, the spheres are almost out of the earth. You will learn about them in your next classes. In the, when you can see a plane is flying, it is mostly in the troposphere and stratosphere in that level. That is the place where there is no disturbance from the clouds. That's the reason planes can fly smoothly on that level. But troposphere, as we can see, the clouds, these all are in the troposphere, the first layer from Earth to the atmosphere. Air is also never fixed anywhere. You know that moving air is known as wind. We can feel it. That is the part of atmosphere we can directly feel. That is wind. Now, whatever we have learned in this, all these domains, it is our responsibility to save them. Not the lithosphere, hydrosphere or atmosphere, they have life, to change themselves. But the biosphere, we have life, and we are spoiling the other three spheres, which we need badly to live, to survive. So we need to think about saving our earth, saving all the other three domains, saving the soil, protecting the lithosphere, hydrosphere to save water, atmosphere to save air pollution and everything. You know that due to air pollution, many schools in Delhi, they were forced to close down. So we need to save atmosphere. And another reason we need to save it, that is, I told you that carbon dioxide is very useful when we are using it the way it must be used. It can grab warmth. But at the same time, if the emission is more, if the carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere is producing more than the quantity it is required, as a result, we can experience global warming. That is really harmful, global warming. What is global warming? Global warming is when the number of the molecule of carbon dioxide that is more in the atmosphere. What will happen? I told you, carbon dioxide can trap heat. As a result, when the number of carbon dioxide molecules are more in the atmosphere, then the heat number, the amount of heat also will be absorbed more. What will happen as a result? We can see here in lithosphere, Antarctica, we consider it as a frozen continent. It is completely frozen. Unfortunately, due to global warming, we can see some movement in this continent. The glaciers are started resolving into water, solving into water. And once this continent will lose the rocky nature and it will considered as an ocean, it will produce more water. Even the Himalaya mountain will not be enough to protect us. The water level will be so high that we cannot live there. We will lose all these continents. So everything is depending on us, how we are protecting our earth, our own earth, how we are protecting our these major domains of the earth. Being the prominent member of biosphere, if we cannot protect these three layers, how the global warming can affect these three? Hydrosphere will be more, lithosphere will be losing, and then atmosphere will be polluted. Can we live in this condition? No way. You know that before few years we have a tsunami. What is a tsunami? Tsunami is nothing but an earthquake under the sea level. So due to the tsunami, we lose some of the land part which was once a part of our own country, India. The Indira Point is no more in India because it is submerged. It is there, but it is submerged in water due to tsunami. So we need to take care of our own earth. We need to save it. We need to stop global warming. We need to take care that the production of carbon dioxide, which we only are responsible, none other part of the biosphere is taking part in that. we need to control the production of carbon dioxide to protect the other three parts of atmosphere and as well as our life in biosphere. Now, let us take a quick recapitulation. What are the four major domains of the earth? They are lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. The major continents of the earth, they are Asia, the largest one, Europe, the smallest one, Africa, the second largest one, then North America, the busiest continent, South America, Australia and the frozen continent, that is Australia is an island continent and the frozen continent is Antarctica. Coming to hydrosphere, the next one, we have four oceans. They are oceans are purely water bodies. The oceans are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Arctic Ocean. The biggest one is Pacific, which has Mariana Trench. Atlantic Ocean is the busiest ocean. Indian Ocean is the only ocean that named after a country. And Arctic Ocean, that is in the North Pole, northern side of the Earth, the North Pole of the Earth. Next, the atmosphere, we have major gases like nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide. 99% of atmosphere is made by these three gases and only 1% we have other gases. Biosphere, next is biosphere means life, where we have life, that is biosphere, mostly made by plants, animals, some biotic and abiotic microbes. Now the next is which two continents are entirely in the southern hemisphere? They are South America and Australia. These two hemisphere, they are entirely in the southern hemisphere. So what we can see, the rest of the continents like Asia, Europe, Africa, part of Africa, North America, Australia and Antarctica, these South America also, the equator is passing through South America. So Australia and Antarctica, so rest, these five we can see, the five continents, these all five continents are in the northern side. What we can see as a result, the most of the lithosphere content is in the northern hemisphere, whereas most of the hydrosphere we can find is in southern hemisphere. Why biosphere is important for living organism? We cannot leave entire part of this domains. All part of lithosphere is not accessible. I told you, in hydrosphere we cannot live on the oceans. Atmosphere, only a little part of atmosphere is accessible for biosphere. So the part we can leave, that is known only as biosphere, and we need to be careful to save that part, otherwise life will be impossible. Global warming is the major concern in our life, that carbon dioxide gas which is trapping warmth, heat, that is working negatively when it is the number of carbon dioxide molecules are more in the atmosphere. So we need to take care of that. That is at a glance the chapter, the major domains of the earth.